Hi, today I will show you how to make a bug request in case you find a bug in KDE software. And since it's not that easy, I will show you all of the steps doing it myself and doing actually a brand new account to show you that it actually works. So let's get into our desktop, and let's go into Firefox, and the page that we want, of course, is bugs.kde.org. And you will get here and you need to open a new account. You have to make a new one, and then you insert your mail address. In this case, it's nicola@venerandi.com. And by the way, this is also the mail I reply to. So if you have any question about this, this is the actual email, nicola@venerandi.com. I open up the email, mail.google.com, and a confirmation email has been sent. I think this is pretty straightforward, but let's show it. Here we have confirm account creation, and in here there is a link with a token. You just click on it and then you go with your name, which is Nicolò Venerandi, your password, which is Candy Crush Saga 7, you create, and you're in. This is your account, and you can finally file a bug, which is this big blue icon, and then you need to guess. It's a bit of guessing the right place for it. So if you don't know which one specifically you're looking for, and as you can see there's lots of them, you can send me an email. Generally speaking, if it's an issue with a certain application, then it's pretty easy, because you just search for the name of the application, like Dolphin, that's it, or I don't know, Kate, that's it, very easy. If it's part of the desktop, it's not that easy, because there's no, I don't know, there's Plasma Shell, I guess, but it's not always there that you actually have to file the bug. But in case you get it wrong, don't worry. If you're having a bug with Plasma, which is all of KDE except the apps, basically, Plasma Shell in this case is probably multi-purpose, so it's not even like the desktop one. I wonder if there's Plasma Desktop separate, like in a separate way, no? Yeah, Plasma Shell is probably the one that you want to pick 99% of the time when you're doing with Plasma. If it's related to your theme, it might be Breeze, it might be Plasma Framework, which here is called Plasma Free. Sorry, I can do this. Plasma Frameworks is not a separated place you can file bugs to, in which case it's probably Plasma Shell, I guess. Still, you have to kind of understand the search for what the bug is. Let's make, as an example, a bug indeed for Plasma Shell, and this one. So this is the bug entering place, and don't panic. You have to select a component, which is a subset of Plasma Shell. Depending on the product, this will be different, but it should be intuitive. So activity switcher is the one on the left when you switch activity. Analog clock is the widget with the actual clock. Application launcher kickoff is the one on the bottom left. Application menu is the one that you can select from alternatives of kickoff, and so on. Data engines, I hope you don't have to file back about that unless you know what that is. Desktop containment is the actual desktop on the background with the files and stuff. Edit mode toolbar is the one on the top when you're in edit mode. Folder, I don't know, I guess it, no, it's the folder applet, sorry, there's even a description. It's a folder applet that you can add on your desktop. General, if you don't know what component to select. Generic crash, if it crashes. Generic performance, if it's a performance bug. Global menu, another applet, global theme packages, and so on. I won't list them all, but you get the idea. You even get a description. Then the version of your Plasma master, severity, leave normal if you're just a user. If you're a developer, of course, you know what severity you need to put. Platform, well, you select your distro. Debian stable, and then is there a KDE? It's probably Ubuntu, where is it? Ubuntu packages. OS, you probably select Linux. Summary, this is happening. And then description. And in theory, this should be easy to do. If you're reporting a crash, it's different, but otherwise, in here, you do a short summary, which is longer than the shorter summary, which is the title, explaining what is happening. And then the steps to reproduce, which are particularly important. So what did you do to actually find this bug? What you see happening after the steps? What should be happening after the steps? And then you repeat again the version of the software. You delete the Windows and macOS lines if you're not using them. You search for the Linux and KDE Plasma version, Frameworks version, Qt versions, and the Linux version. I guess KDE Plasma is technically here, so this is Linux. Additional information could be anything else. You can add an attachment here. You can choose file and you go to pictures and select one like this. And this will be uploaded. If, I don't know, it's like Plasma, I don't know, the panel in here, you can see similar bugs because maybe there is a bug opened already about that. And you just click on submit bug and it's that easy. In theory, it should be something that everybody can do. If for whatever reason you're unable to send me an email, I'll try to help. And what is cool is that now that you signed up, you can even see all of the bug reports in the last 24 hours or 7 days. And as an example, today I can speak properly, I'm sorry. These are all of the bugs in the last 24 hours. And the very latest one at time of recording is on KDE Connect from Android. Share a link directly to the phone via KDE Connect applet. And you can see that this bug has an issue, which is it actually lacks this summary. Like there's the title, but there's not the, it lacks the description rather than the summary. And it's not very clear, like share a link directly to the phone via the KDE Connect applet. I guess this is a feature request, but it should be clearer. And status reported, you can, if you're a developer, change this, but if you change this and you're not a developer, don't do that. You can also, and this is cool, see the bugs assigned to you if you're a developer, but you shouldn't be if you're watching this video. But you can also some more, which is probably, thank you, Chrome. In here, you can click on this button, which is reports, and you can see reports of the how KDE is doing in terms of bugs. As an example, graphical reports, if you want graphs, and this will generate a graph. You have to select a lot of stuff here, but you can also do old chart, which is a bit easier to do if I remember correctly. As an example, if we want a chart of confirmed bugs for everything, here is it. This is the graph. So as you can see, it starts in 2000 and then it goes up slowly until this peak, which is in 2011. And then it goes down thanks to the effort of the bug squashing team till 2018. And then something goes wrong and it goes up again. So if you want to help with that, well, you even got the stats. Right now, KDE has 12,000 open bugs. And we can go back and select not only confirmed, but also unconfirmed or assigned or reopened. That's also something cool. You still go see the graph. And you see that the trend is that unconfirmed bugs are much more than confirmed ones, and they're right now both increasing. This day, which is 2018, something happened for which a lot of bugs were triaged, that is moved from unconfirmed to something else, probably automatically given it's that certain day and it's a lot. But still, it's pretty cool to look at this graph. So if you're data person, lots of stats. And that's it, really. This is the KDE bug tracking platform. And in theory, there is also KDE invent with GitLab, and GitLab also has bugs, but currently those are not used except for exceptions, rarely. For bugs, they're not used to for users to actually do open bugs. Again, I can speak. But only for developers to discuss things. Maybe that will change in the future. Right now, there's Bugzilla, which has a new theme. It's even pretty. So this is how you do it. If you have issues, email me. It's better to email me. I won't get offended. Worst case scenario, I'm busy and I don't reply. But best case scenario, we actually figure out how to add the bug here. So any issue, write me. Thanks everybody who sponsored this video, and I'm not talking about companies, I'm talking about all of the people in the other direction that are actually donating me through like PayPal and Patreon and LibraPay, and thank you really because it helps me do these videos. And today I was a bit tired, but tomorrow I'll be back with a more exciting video hopefully. And if you think this video was too boring, well, I've got many done in the days past, so go see them, go check them out. See you tomorrow still.